رمضان هلله لاله وظلاله.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah ta'ala has blessed us with this great month, the month of Ramadan. إذا سلم رمضان سلمة السنة. How a Muslim spends this month, then guaranteed your year will go well with you, insha'Allah. Similarly with Jumu'ah, إذا سلمت الجمعه سلمت الأيام. How a Muslim spends correctly the day, the Friday, the day of Jumu'ah, then the entire week will go well with that Muslim. This is how beautiful the teachings of Islam is. Yes, my honorable viewers, you're on Soul Food, and subhanAllah, this is the month of getting closer to Allah. The month of getting closer to Allah, as one person said, has become the month of getting close to friends, socializing. Gone are those old days, our elders can speak about it, what great respect they had for this month of Ramadan. Not only that, myself being a Cape Townian, I can gladly say my father, for example, he was a bricklayer of a builder by trade. But when it came to month of Ramadan, they had that utmost respect. If they did work, they would work. They would still go to work and still fast. And subhanAllah, they'd make sure that they perform their salahs on time. And when they would come for their taraweeh, they had a special cloth on. They did not just come with all respect. Today, we just come with the jeans. We come with ragged clothing. We come just, even the women folk with all respect, they just throw over them a baya and there's nothing underneath even. That was a sign of the taqwa of those times. And today, there's not even a worry of coming with a topi to the masjid. And our thoughts has gone different. My beloved brothers and sisters and honorable viewers to ITV, وَمَنْ يُعَذِّمْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ, whoever shows reverence and respect to the symbols of Allah, the likes of the month of Ramadan, and zoom into the lives of our elders and our pious predecessors, how they honored this month, how you honor something, that is how you're going to get back the blessings of that. So if we want to be blessed for the entire 11 months after Ramadan, then we ought to give our utmost to this great month, our utmost to this guest, the fasting, the Quran, the Taraweeh that has visited our homes. But as this honorable scholar says, that the month of getting closer to Allah has become a month of getting close to friends, socializing. We don't really socialize in the other 11 months of the year because we are too busy. But suddenly we find a time, because of fasting, that we can just chill around. Just socialize in the malls with some coffee after just breaking fast there. And then we talk, ha, 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 ha. And then we pass our taraweeh, you know. And as ladies also, we are just chilling. There's not a deeper concern. What is this month all about? It is not just going for taraweeh or just having heard a piece on Laylatul Qadr and thinking, I've got it all. No, there is, when you go for chemotherapy, you have to go per week and you have to be there on time at a certain sessions. If you skip, it's detrimental to your own well-being. Here, Allah Azza wa Jalla has designed every night of Taraweeh itself is precious. Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaba. Whoever stands every night, just standing in that Taraweeh at your close local masjid, and listening to that rhythm of the Quran beat, subhanAllah, Allah is doing radium treatment, chemotherapy of your soul. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, Khairud dawa al-Quran. The best of natural, pure medication to cleanse the soul of all the toxic past is just to listen to the tilawat of the Quran, or for yourself to scan it with your own eyes, and subhanAllah, you'll find so much more meaning. And with that beautiful rhythm that our Hufaz are reciting, definitely there comes something into our hearts. May Allah give us understanding, inshallah. So every human is a slave. You're either a slave of your desires, or you choose to bring a change to yourself and realize, I am a slave ultimately of my Creator, Allah. You either live life by your rules, or you live it by the rules that Allah has ordained for us of 5 salahs on its set time. Jumu'ah, a big day on its set time. The month of Ramadan on its set time. The days of Hajj on its set time. And as I said earlier on, whoever shows that respect for this great month of Ramadan, even though thou art excused of fasting, but you show the respect for all those. Some of us might even go to work and have a certificate to say I'm allowed to eat. But it doesn't mean you're going to eat your Gatsby in front of everyone there and putting yourself on a show. You should have respect. Do you know, I know certain Christian fellow members and colleagues and friends at work. They would not even puff a cigarette nor eat their meal which they are entitled to because 2 colleagues are Muslim in their surrounds. So they would show that respect and they would go somewhere else because just to show that we have respect, these brothers and sisters, they are staying away from things that is lawful for them, but because for this great month. So just that showing that respect, they are blessed also with that respect. May Allah give us that respect, inshallah. So, my dear viewers, how can the heart travel to Allah? How can this heart of ours travel to Allah if it's chained by its desires? And as our ulama explains to us in Ramadan, the shaitan is chained, but the nafs, the ego is still there. So hence our fight in the month of Ramadan is between me and my nafs, and not between me and the shaitan. Nafs was fed for 11 months, and the real fast is the blossoming of that inner heart. Allah takes a qasam, Allah takes an oath by the sun, by the moon, by the stars, by the galaxy, by day, by night. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Successful is that one, triumph is that one who purifies the inner. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. On the flip side of the coin, Allah says, ruin, destruction to you when you are neglectful to that inner self of you. Yeah, Allah Ta'ala is giving us this month of Ramadan for us to internalize and to stop that animal instincts within its tracks. And that's why you cannot eat those meats, you cannot eat those chicken, that fish, you cannot drink, you cannot eat whatever the nafs desire. You have to curb it so that you can identify where is your shortcomings, where really is your weaknesses. And now, if you can put that brakes onto that nafs, then the doors of Jannah starts opening for you. May Allah make it easy for me and you, inshallah. That is why Rasulullah said, rather be alone than being with bad company. I'm talking about socializing. I'm not saying the guys are bad, but think for yourself, bro. If it's a time of Ramadan, a good guy will say, hey, let's go chill at the masjid. We want to socialize. This month is to socialize with the Creator. He has given us so much of bonuses, and we want much more in this world and in the afterlife. Let us socialize with our Creator. Subhanallah. If you want to have a real joyous Eid, you can socialize for that whole day and 3 days thereafter with all your brothers and everyone else and entertain him to the brim. It's only when you got that certificate to say, Subhanallah, I've got my Laylatul Qadr. I've got my full khatam of the Quran. I have a full tarawih I've listened to. I've enjoyed the spirit of sitting at the sufra, sitting at the table of all the poor people. I took dates there and I sat with them and I told mama or my wife to make soup with the poor. And I could see on those faces, hey, I'm sure I got Jibreel alayhi salam's blessings. I've got every night the du'as of the malaika, the angels. Then you can socialize on the day of Eid and 3 days thereafter also. May Allah give us understanding. So you know, the Prophet ﷺ reminds us, rather be alone than to be with bad company. And rather be with good company than to be also alone. The month of getting close to the masjid has become a month of getting close to restaurants and cafes. All in the name of convenience. But look how smart it's appealing to us. I'm not saying you don't go to a restaurant, although home food is the best. I'm not saying don't go to a cafe and chill, but to what extent? No other month throughout the year we chill so long like in the month of Ramadan. We are passing time because we are still feeding the nafs, the baseless desires. We have not understood what is the month of Ramadan. So the most important message of Ramadan is that we are not just a body. We are a body, a soul, and that makes us human beings. That determines our value, my beloved viewers, as human beings. During Ramadan, we deprive the body to uplift the soul in order to rediscover, realign our inner self. Subhanallah. Ramadan is also for us a month to reflect on the direction of our lives, our priorities, and to strengthen our relationship with our Creator. And that is why Allah Ta'ala is calling us in the Quran, where Allah says, Ya ibadi fattakuni. Oh, my devoted ones, it's ultimately me that you ought to be conscious of. We pray and make dua that Allah Ta'ala give us guidance. Antal hadi, antal haq, laysa laha hadi illahu. Oh Allah, you are the source of guidance. You are the ultimate, the absolute truth. None can guide me but you. Oh Allah, Allahumma ati nafsi taqwaha, grant my soul the desired taqwa. Zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha, purify this inner self. Only thou hast the means and the tools to rectify my life, oh Allah. Bring my life back on the sirat al-mustaqim. Wa ma tawfiq illa billah, wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وظلاله وجماله رمضان رمضان هل هلاله وظلاله.